Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Pokemon Platinum. So right now, we are about to take on the second Elite Four member. So let's just check up on our team before we head on out, because I did some little adjustments. Basically, I realized I had four rare candies in my item bag, so I definitely wanted to use them, seeing how it's basically the end of the game, and this is the best time to use them, because we're taking on the Elite Four, so yeah. I gave two to Torterra, and by doing that, at level 51, Torterra learned a new move, Giga Drain, and I actually got rid of Razor Leaf for this, because I think Giga Drain's it's a more powerful move, that being Razor Leaf was 55, this one's 60. Plus, Giga Drain can heal myself up, and that might come in handy later on when I have to heal myself up without even using any healing items, but I think it's a pretty good idea to have that, so yeah, that was my choice to do. And the other two rare candies went to Bronzong and Vaporeon. Wow, look at Vaporeon's freaking HP right there, oh my god. He's gotten it rather high, he's the highest one, I think. He's more than Torterra, yeah, wow, by a lot. That's a lot of HP right there. But anyway, without further ado, let's head on out to the second Gym Elite. Elite Four member, Ooh, we got some rocks in here, Are you a rock-type trainer, a ground-type trainer? Well, let's find out, and you're a girl.
Well, well, you're quite the adorable trainer, but you've also got a spine. Ah, I'm Bertha. I have a preference for ground-type Pokemon. Well, would you show this old lady how much you've learned?
So we're gonna take on Bertha. Wow, I was expecting her to be, like, fat or something. I don't know, that's like a fat person's name, but anyway. Oh man, anyway, she'll start off with a level 50 Whiscash with the moves Earth Power, Zen Headbutt, Sandstorm, and Aqua Tail. So, as you notice, that's why I start off with Torterra, because quad effectiveness. Yes, its only weakness is grass, so definitely want to use a grass type move or a grass type user. And this should take it out in one turn, I'm assuming. But you know, in a Pokemon game, it's never a good thing to assume, because you'll have a major letdown if it doesn't work. Like that! There you go! Perfect case in point scenario. And it got off Oh, that's just great. That is just beautiful. Now I'm probably gonna have to use my Giga Drain again, because watch this. She heals up! Aw, man, this one's going great already. Oh, great, so now I have to waste another Giga Drain, and that's 8 left, because, bad side effect of Giga Drain only has 10 PP, as opposed to Razor Leaf having 25, so. Oh, well, what are you gonna do? It's not like Razor Leaf was good anyway, because in the earlier games, it used to be the best move ever because of the high critical hit ratio, but now, not so much, sadly. I'm assuming it's not going to heal himself again, so I think I'm just going to go with the Crunch. Oh, there we go. And Whiscash is Whiscone. I felt kind of bad defeating one of my former Pokemon. Had some sentimental value there. Well, with Sandstorm, eh. Does that power up ground-type moves, or maybe? I don't know. I think it does. I don't know if it does, though. The world may never know, I guess. Her next Pokemon is Gliscor. To beat a Gliscor, let's actually put out Vaporeon, because it's part ground and part flying, so an ice-type would be, quad. Okay, there you go. Definitely want to use Vaporeon. But anyway, her Gliscor is level 53. Knowing Earthquake, Fire Fang, Ice Fang, and Thunder Fang. That's a lot of fangs. I don't know why she would give it all those fang moves, but you know Gliscor has a high attack power because I have one, you've seen it. And Ice Beam already has 2 left, god. I really used in that first fight, didn't I? I guess I'll have to use an Elixir on it soon, or an Aether, whatever I have in my little sack. And that sounded wrong and suggestive, but anyway, let's see if this one takes it out, and it does! Gliscor is done! Another one of my Pokemon. What, is she gonna copy all my former Pokemon slash active Pokemon? Come on, man, you're an Elite Four member. Have some class. Alright, our next Pokemon is Golem, okay. So now we're going back to like a Bruno-esque kind of trainer here. I don't know, all our Pokemon are not really that great in my opinion, but anyway, level 52 Golem, knowing Fire Punch, Earthquake, Thunder Punch, and Sandstorm, so again, more punches, or this time punches, fangs, same thing basically. It's Sandstorm and Earthquake, so I think everyone on her team has Earthquake, so not really much of a surprise there. Because she is a ground type trainer after all. Let's see what this Surf does. Come on, baby. There we go. Critical at... Wow. Alright, that helps. I don't think I even needed that critical too, so it kind of stings. Ooh, her best Pokemon right there. I'll leave in Vaporeon. Why not? Got the type advantage. She all has these ground-type Pokemon. And anyway, like I said, sir, strongest Pokemon by far, probably. Level 55, Rhyperior, the evolved form of Rhydon, knowing Avalanche, which is kind of a weird move, Earthquake, Mega Horn, and Rock Wrecker. Yeah, that move is basically like a rock version of Hyper Beam. It is pretty powerful, but if she hits it and I end up surviving, she loses a turn, so it could end up being in my favor, so I guess we'll find out what happens if she tries to use it. Hopefully I don't get die in one hit, because then I think she doesn't have to recharge. Alright, let's see how much this does. Wow! Are you kidding me? Oh my god! Wow! I took it out in one shot? Really? I didn't think my Vaporeon was that strong, but wow! Her best Pokemon went down like that. I'm just still flabbergasted. That's the word I would describe that as. Flabbergasted. Hmm. I don't know, Vaporeon, stay in there. You're on a freaking roll. I thought this gym, this Elite Four fight would be much harder than that. Alright, so let's just keep doing surf. And whoa! Quick Claw, nice. Ah, I'm so enthused by this winning. Winning. And come on, get down there. This would be the quickest Elite Four fight ever, and you had to disappoint. Oh well, Hippopoudon, level 52, and you used Yawn, one of your moves, along with Earthquake, Stone Edge, and Crunch. Alright, so I just thought Rhyperior would be the strongest of your bunch. Dear child, don't assume that you won an instant. Alright, so, another Surf should be able to do it. I think we won! Yeah, there we go, okay, I thought I was going to do a healing-type move there, or a healing-type, item, but nope. Just like that. Bertha is defeated. Wow, what a major disappointment. Vaporeon took care of that team so quickly. Oh my god. Her strongest Pokemon, ironically, was Whiscash. Who would have thunk it? Well, dear child, I must say that I am most impressed. Your Pokemon believed in you and did their best to earn you a win. Even though I've lost, I found myself with a silly grin. Ah, your team sucks. How about that? You're quite something, youngster. I like how you and your Pokemon earned the win by working as one. That's why it makes you strong. Aha! I think that you can go as far as you want. Wow, I wasn't actually expecting to beat Bertha that fast. I don't know, but I want to keep it all in one part of each Elite Four member, so I'm going to end it here, even though I probably can take on the next person in time, but... Oh well, I'll leave off on a bit of a little cliffhanger, but not really. So yes, we defeated the second Elite Four member really fast. Oh my god. I still can't get over how fast I beat her. I don't know, I never beat an Elite Four member that quickly before. But anyway, yes, we'll have to end it here. Thank you guys for watching. Next time, we'll take on the third Elite Four member. Can you guess who it is? But anyway, I think you'll find out next time. So, I'll see you guys then. Later.